how do you make people care about a psychopath was the question that kept coming up early on. And the answer is cast Jodie Comer.
She is Villanelle, and she's given her this extraordinary charisma that we genuinely only dreamt we'd achieve in casting.
She does her kills, she gets her money, she spends her money on what she likes. She has no one around her to tell her what to do.
She's desperately trying to be a normal human being, but at the same time, she has this kind of feeling that she is above everybody. Talking to Christian the whole time about the flat, he really ran with it. I mean, all I said to him was she has style, but she also doesn't really completely know who she is. He managed to crash those two things together so beautifully. So when you walk into this gorgeous flat that she owns, it does still feel like a young woman in her 20s who just happens to have wigs and guns in her drawers.
You want the space to look real? So I need to, you know, you get all the fittings from France. We make the mood boards, so we make sure that all the colours work together, make sure that, you know, the detailing of the flat is right. And you adapt it a little bit to make it film-friendly.
If you look around the apartment, there's loads of little knick-knacks that just don't look like they belong in the same room. But I feel like they're probably all little things that she's collected. You know, she travels a lot.
If you go to most people's houses, the furniture isn't all bought at the same time. It's acquired over time. And so we've tried to give that impression of something that has organically developed.
It's one thing of building a space that looks aesthetically pleasing. It is more important to have a space that can work for the drama, for the camera, and for the actors.
For me, I'm always very super keen to work out with the production designer up front how I'm going to light it. So what will be built into the design of the set that will facilitate the lighting being, you know, the right atmosphere and doing what you want it to do. As a cinematographer, we always hope that we will shoot the exteriors first and then come into the interiors in a studio or wherever they are on location and be able to match them in. The lighting rigs that we put in are designed to accommodate the sort of mixture of soft, cloudy light, a lot of which we had in Paris.
She speaks so many languages, and depending on the mission that she's going on, she will have a set costume and hair and like a totally different life that she just kind of morphs into.
She's got this chameleon quality where she can flip between characters.
She'll be standing in the queue for catering, or you'll be on set, suddenly you realise that it's Jodie.
There was a scene that we shot in Paris where she's at her most mischievous, really, and she puts on this big puffy dress anyway.
The thing with Villanelle, she gets a kick from doing these kills. It excites her and it gives her purpose.
She's brought so much complexity to this character and so much vulnerability to her. And this wild, fantastical character has been right, really brought down to earth. You'll make the mistake of falling in love with her and then she will kill you.